I'm Nikki Worrell and I'm the Children and Families Worker here at St Mark's. I really want to welcome you to our All Age Worship Service today. Whatever your age, and whether you're a regular at St Mark's or you've just found us on the internet, you are so welcome. There are some additional activities for younger members to do alongside the service today if they want to, as well as some reflections and conversation starters for all of us. So the sheet is on the web page or can be downloaded, so do have a look at that. Children might also like to have a small box and some craft materials ready to make a prayer box later. And everybody might need a small stone and a small piece of paper, again, for our prayer time. Oh, and don't forget a pen. Well, today is the 72nd anniversary of the NHS, and our prayers later will focus on the fantastic work of the NHS. During the service, there are bits for you to join in with, so any words you need will appear on the screen as you need them. So we say a gathering prayer together. Father God, we come to you to find rest today. Help us to be ready to learn from you. Amen.
God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. Our God is a great big God. And he holds us in his hands.
We have a game today, and we're going to be going over to the Curtis family now for a three-legged race. Now your part of the game is going to be to look at the pairs and to decide which pair you think is going to win. So over to our St Mark's three-legged race. Wow, what an exciting race this is. We're at the halfway point now. How's your team doing? Let's see. Well, what an exciting race that was. I wonder whether your pair won. Well, these games always have a tenuous link, and the tenuous link this time to our theme is about being joined with Jesus, and we'll find out more about that as we go further into our service. And now Rebecca will bring us our reading.
The reading today is taken from Matthew 11 verses 25 to 30. Rest for all who are tired. At that time, Jesus said, I praise you, Father. You are Lord of heaven and earth. You have hidden these things from wise and educated people, but you have shown them to little children. Yes, Father, this is what you wanted to do. My Father has given all things to me. The Father is the only one who knows the Son, and the only ones who know the Father are the Son and those to whom the Son chooses to make him known. Come to me, all you who are tired and are carrying heavy loads. I will give you rest. Become my servants and learn from me. I am gentle and free of pride. You will find rest for your souls. Serving me is easy and my load is light.
Well, we've come to the part of our service where we have our talk, and we're going to begin with a question. What makes you feel tired and weary? I wonder whether it's going for a long walk, cooking a big meal, or running a race. Maybe it's when you can't sleep at night, or cutting the grass, or spending a whole day doing your homeschooling. There are lots of things that make us tired, and sometimes we just feel like we need a rest. Well, Jesus said, come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. So we can do all those good things like sit down, have a cuppa, have a sleep. But Jesus was talking about those things in life that make us really tired. And he says we can go to him. Now, have you ever had to lift something really heavy or awkward? Sometimes you just cannot do it on your own and you need somebody to help you. Well, Jesus talked about taking his yoke upon us. But yoke? What was he talking about? Well, this would have made total sense to the people at the time, because they knew all about farming. Now in the pictures, you can see two oxen standing side by side, and then another two in the picture below that are ploughing a field together. Well, they would have been placed together using the yoke, which is that piece of wood that went across them and around their necks. Together, they could then share the load. But even better than that, one of those oxen would have been an older, more experienced animal who knew exactly what to do. And the other was a younger one who needed to learn. So not only were they sharing the job, but one was learning from the other. Now, I wonder whether you've ever entered a three-legged race. Now, what a great example of this we had earlier. So thank you to the Curtis family. When my sister and I were younger, we were in the girls' brigade and we became very skilled at the three-legged race. And my memory is of us winning quite often. We would practice in our garden at home to prepare for our competitions. Now, not everybody finds a three-legged race very easy at all. But when you're in tune with each other, it does work, and a little bit of practice also helps. Now, many of you will remember the race in which Johnny Brownlee, who you can see on the right, became so exhausted that it looked like he wasn't going to be able to finish his race. But his brother Alistair came alongside him and supported him so that he could end the race and get over the finish line. Well, Jesus said, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." Jesus isn't talking about helping you carry the sofa up three flights of stairs, but he is talking about the things that worry us. If we go to him, he will take the weight of that thing that we are finding hard, and he helps to make it feel much lighter. He is telling us to take our worries to him. Amen.
Our Father everlasting, Thee, your creating one, God Almighty, through your Holy Spirit, conceiving Christ the Son, Jesus our Savior. I believe in God our Father, I believe in Christ the Son, I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. Our judge and our defender suffered and crucified. I believe in
So now we come to our time of prayer. Later in our prayers, John will help us to say thank you to the NHS and pray for them. And during this, the children might like to draw or write prayers for the doctors and nurses and other people who work for the NHS. Or you could start decorating your prayer box if you decide to do that activity. But first, let's think what Jesus says to us. We can take our worries to him. And this is where you will need a small stone and a small piece of paper and a pen. On the paper, write or draw anything that you're worried about for yourself, your family, anybody you know, our country, our world. I'm going to give you some space to do that. So now hold your stone and remember that Jesus will bear the weight of our burdens. He will help us with things that we're worried about. And so we pray. Father God, when we are worried, we know that you are there and ready to help bear our burdens. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the life, work and vision of those who founded our National Health Service. We give thanks too for those who, since 1948, have served in the NHS with care and compassion, and for those who continue to serve today. We pray that their work and ministry to the sick may enrich and support the welfare of all. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Heavenly Father, we give thanks for all who provide leadership in healthcare, for those who exercise stewardship and allocate resources, and we pray that in these challenging times, support and love may always be shown to those most in need. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Heavenly Father, we pray for all who promote health and well-being in policy and practice, for all who care for the sick in hospital, in care homes and at home, for doctors, for nurses, for care assistants, for cleaners. And we seek guidance and strength for all chaplains and for all those engaged in teaching and medical research. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Heavenly Father, we pray for those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, for those who are terminally ill, for the elderly and frail, for all who live with a disability or who are in constant pain. And we pray for the many who strive to bring comfort and healing to them. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Heavenly Father, remember in your kingdom all those who have faithfully served you here on earth and who are now at rest, and especially those who have followed in the footsteps of St. Luke the physician. Grant us, with them and with all the faithful departed, the joy of your salvation. We commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to your mercy and protection. So keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy in this time of uncertainty and distress. Support the anxious and fearful, lift up all who are brought low, and sustain all health workers and carers. May we rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Well, I hope that you have enjoyed worshipping with us today. Let's all accept the invitation that Jesus gives to be joined with him and allow him to help us carry our burdens. We're going to end this service with a well-known hymn and the Grenoside version of the blessing song. But now, let's join together with a sending out prayer. Lord Jesus, as we go from here, give us eyes to see what you are doing in the world so we can learn more of you. Amen.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father.